If JavaScript is your first programming language, I bet you're excited, but also maybe a little nervous and not sure what to expect. That's natural. I too felt a bit intimidated and out of my comfort zone when I first started learning JavaScript. There were a lot of new terms and concepts introduced. It wasn't until I fully immersed myself in the language that I started to pick up quite a bit. Concepts began to stick, and code looked more and more familiar over time. So this JavaScript Basics course, along with other follow-along courses, is intended to guide you and help get you immersed in the JavaScript language with quizzes, code challenges, practice opportunities, and more. It's going to be challenging, but also awesome and rewarding. I'm excited for you. Before you get started programming, I want to talk about what I'll cover in this course. JavaScript is a programming language, and like any language, it has its own vocabulary and grammar. Programmers call this syntax. A programming language's syntax is the rules of the language, or the instructions, special words, and punctuation you use to put together a program. Every programming language has its own syntax, just as English, Spanish, and Mandarin each have their own vocabulary and grammar. I'll also teach you basic programming concepts. These concepts won't just apply to JavaScript. They're common ideas you'll find in other programming languages like Python, Java, or PHP. For example, variables, data types, and conditional statements. I'll teach you the concepts I think you should focus on at this particular part of your journey. And don't worry about remembering or fully understanding everything right away. This is a journey, and you're just getting started. As a programmer, it's also important to be able to talk like a programmer. So I'll introduce important vocabulary that's useful for you to know. These are programming terms that will come up often as you read, talk, and learn about JavaScript and programming, like the word syntax, which again is a programming language's vocabulary and grammar. Lastly, you'll learn important programming techniques. These are best practices or proven ways to put together programs so they work better. For example, you'll learn how to use comments to make your programs easier to understand and use. I'll also model for you the process of basic debugging techniques or finding errors in your code. Making mistakes, sometimes mistakes that feel silly, are all part of the role of being a programmer, so it's important to practice finding and fixing those errors. Errors can often be your greatest teachers, too. Learning alone can be challenging, but remember, you're not taking this course alone. There are many other students, some of whom are programming for the first time, taking this course right now. So I encourage you to make use of your support structure, like the amazing community and tools we offer to help you meet other students, ask questions, and talk about what you're learning. Also, with each video is a detailed set of teacher's notes. Now, I'll do my best to point out when there's something in there that you have to review, but try to get in the habit of checking the notes for additional resources, examples, and helpful tips.